Hello, Dr. Brian Desvonik here. Is fatigue ruining your life? Well, maybe the cause can be determined by ordering basic laboratory tests. In this video, I will be discussing the most common tests that I order for my patients to determine the cause of their fatigue. And with this information, you could either ask your doctor to order these tests, or you can go online to many of the online labs and order the test yourself. I'll provide links down below to several of those labs. But before we get started, I ask that you hit the subscribe button and click the little bell so that you can stay notified of all the wonderful content I put out on a weekly basis. All right, let's get started. I always ask my new patients, what are their health goals? And in many cases, at least one of their goals is they want to improve energy. It seems like nowadays everyone is just wiped out. Ordering the right test could save you time and money. So if you are experiencing fatigue, here are the top basic lab tests that you should have ordered. Number one, a complete blood count or CBC. This test shows you if you have anemia, and the most common cause of anemia is due to a nutrition deficiency. This patient had low hemoglobin, so their fatigue was likely due to an iron deficiency. Other nutrient deficiencies which can cause anemia are low vitamin B12 and low folic acid. And that brings me to the next basic lab panel, the anemia panel. Iron, B12, and folic acid are tested in this panel. Here's what the iron panel looks like. This patient had a low serum iron and low percent saturation. She was prescribed iron bisglycinate, which is the best form of iron in a supplement. I made a video about this on my other YouTube channel, and you can view it by clicking the link in the description below. This patient here had fatigue and was found to have low vitamin B12. I consider a vitamin B12 below 500 to be low. This patient doesn't eat animal meat or byproducts of animals, which is the only natural dietary source of B12. So I give her injections of methylcobalamin once a month in my office, and she now has normal energy. This test is the MTHFR DNA test. Instead of testing for folic acid directly, I test for genetic abnormalities in how the body converts dietary folic acid into a bioavailable form. This patient had a single genetic mutation on both genes that were tested. As a result of a genetic abnormality, this patient does not adequately convert dietary folic acid into a usable form. I prescribed 5-MTHF, which is activated folic acid, and it improved his energy as well as other issues he had. The next panel is one of my favorites. It's the thyroid panel. This here is a beautiful example of a patient with low thyroid. I always test TSH, or thyroid stimulating hormone, which is an indirect measure of thyroid function, and free T3 and free T4, which are direct measures of thyroid function. Here you can see this patient's TSH was way high, and his free T3 and free T4 were way low. He had severe fatigue, and he required pharmaceutical thyroid treatment. I prescribed Natrathroid, and his energy dramatically improved. As a side note, I ran additional thyroid testing to determine the cause of his low thyroid. Two different markers of autoimmune thyroid disease, or Hashimoto's, were present. I'm fascinated by thyroid conditions. If you or anyone you know has a low thyroid problem, please comment down below. I would love to hear yours or their story. This next test is my favorite lab test of all time. Although abnormalities don't necessarily cause you to have fatigue, in many cases, people who have abnormalities do have fatigue. And this test is the hemoglobin A1C. This test shows what your average blood sugar was over the past 3 months. Depending on how high the number is, the hemoglobin A1C test shows if you have insulin resistance, or even worse, type 1 or type 2 diabetes. The higher the number, the worse the condition is, and the more fatigue the patient has. I diagnosed this patient with type 2 diabetes, and she had moderate fatigue. We got her blood sugar under control with dietary changes, and her energy improved. This patient's hemoglobin A1C was very high. I won't get into the details in this video, but with additional testing seen here, I diagnosed this patient with type 1 diabetes. I prescribed insulin and the patient's hemoglobin A1C dropped to normal and his energy improved. If you've had all these tests done already and your lab values were all normal and you're still feeling fatigue, then maybe it's another issue that can be determined with further lab testing. If I haven't already, I will be making a video on advanced tests for fatigue. If you see a link up above here, then I've already made the video. If not, please make sure that you hit the subscribe button and click the little bell so that you could be notified for whenever I do put the video out. If you like this video, consider giving it a thumbs up. I thank you for watching and we'll see you in the next one.